And thank you for calling in and sharing that amazing love story.
Thanks, John.
You know, your mother was, we miss her.
Amen.
I guess that's the short and simple way of saying that we could take another 3 hours, and maybe in the next coming days we'll get that opportunity just to wax on about how much she meant to us and the way she... but I wanted to say she was my friend. And in the end, that's what was the special part for me. You know, she loved me. I knew that. But in the end, just to sit up and share some time together and as we did and laugh and some of the things and just to know I miss my friend. I'm going to leave it at that. I'm going to cut it short.
Okay.
So I'll go back to this.
Thanks. All right. Talk to you soon.
Thank you. Tracy has some more questions.
Yeah, I have two questions that maybe you guys can answer for us, okay? Our great listener, Rufus Cunningham, asked, what do you think about counseling before you get married? And most of you have answered that.
Yes.
And suppose it doesn't work in counseling, do you split or do you stay together and try to work it out?
Mm. Preacher, come on and answer that for us. Yeah.
I got one more question.
Do you really want to get married?
Right.
If that's what you want to do, then you work it out, and you will get married. You'll have a successful marriage. Just remember that there's three facts that we can say. Marriages are built.
Yes.
And marriages are always under construction. Now, if you don't remember those first two, your marriage will end up short.
Amen.
All right. Thank you, Rufus.
Go ahead, Brandon. Written down, but for amazing love, it's not the Big Bang Theory that everybody think it is. It doesn't just happen.
That's
it's
right.
Not easy, and it takes lots and lots of work. Amazing love is something that has to be developed, like the pastor said, and nourished over time. You have to feed into it, and one of the key things for success for it is communication.
That's right.
If you don't have the communication, where you going to go with it? And I suggest to everyone, because we have the greatest premarital things that we do at our church. I mean, because this room is filled with the people on the marriage ministry of our churches. And it's
and First Titus, too. First Titus,
too.
St. Titus, right. St. Titus. Give me that right. St.
Titus.
I don't want that pastor calling me saying, you got my church wrong.
Right. So we do suggest to people, go... We do suggest to people that you do to have premarital counseling because it does help. I mean, you don't want to get 6-7 years down the line. We didn't, should have, could have, or whatever, but then it's never too late.
I never understand why on radio people have to look at each other. I just never understand that. Y'all are not looking at the mics and y'all talking.
Because we have an amazing love for
each other. Y'all have just such amazing love that I'm trying to get these people to focus by talking to this mic and they just turn their heads talking to each other.
And ladies and gentlemen,
Tracy
is back.
In the mic.
Tracy is pretty and single. She's looking for a husband, so I'm looking at her.
And radio doesn't show that. Go ahead, Tracy.
I'm telling them.
I have one other question. This question comes from Candace Brown, who asks, how do you deal with love when there's no attraction? I'm assuming she means physical attraction to your spouse.
Wow.
When there's no physical attraction.
And we know that you may start off being attracted because we all start out real cute.
Yes.
But sometimes we lose that attraction for one reason or another.
Oh, no. My hand's up in a different way. Earlier today, my husband was doing something, bending down, and I tripped over the steps looking at him because I was still attracted to him.
Baby.
I was like, oh, and then he laughed because I never really fall and trip in my own house. But I'm like, for some reason, he looked good.
She was doing a Dick Van Dyke, y'all. She was doing a Dick Van Dyke. So let's talk about that, though, because there are times when you get that, that love for each other, but it fades away.
Yes.
What do you do when that happens? How do you get that amazing love back? Somebody talk about it. Sean, you ready.
Yes, I would say take your focus off of your husband and put it back on God, because that's your amazing love. And amazing love is not always a feeling. You have to feel it. Like, I feel in love with him today because he did this or she did that. It's about having that connection with Christ because he died for you. And you know, as you grow in him and know who you are, and I know that our husbands and sometimes we as wives, we let each other down physically, and you know, but to stay spiritually connected will keep your amazing love. You can't always expect it from the other person. You got to have it, and you got to seek it from Christ.
Mm. Okay. Because beauty fades, people. Okay. It fades.
Go ahead, Will.
I was going to say, one of the main things that you have to do is realize that marriage is like an ever-evolving entity. Amen. It's always going to be changing and always going to be going in different directions. What you have to do is you have to go with it. You have to realize that you're not the same person you are you were yesterday. You're going to have different ideas. You're going to have different beliefs. You're going to have different wants, and you're going to have different needs. And the main thing about that is, so is the other person.
Amen. Hey, we got a call in right now, so we're going to go back to that question. Hey, caller, how you doing? Welcome to the Let's Stay Together show.
Yes, this is your brother.
This must be all in the family. Hey, how you doing?
All right. You know, I want to give thanks to you and Brenda for giving a shout-out to Mom on her birthday.
Amen. I thank you for that, brother. Y'all need to stop calling here because y'all going to make me cry on this air.
Yeah, don't have my baby crying.
I mean, you know, such amazing love story. You two have such an amazing love story. So amen. I just want to give both of y'all our blessings and thank you for being the people that you are.
I love you, brother. Thank you very much for giving me that call.
Love you, LB.
Love you. Bye.
Okay, Tracy, go ahead.
Okay, I want to read an answer to the question that we just read from Arlene Adewale. Arlene says, for one, put God first and all other things will fall into place. Two, love and respect each other. Three, be submissive to each other. And I know Arlene. Four, never go against each other. And five, always communicate with each other. Marriage is 100% commitment.
Amen.
You
Amen.
Give your all. Thank you, Arlene.
Thank
hey,
you.
I want to say something right now. We got about 7 minutes with this gift certificate. It's a dinner and a show. So, baby, giving those telephone numbers one more time. You've got to call in and be a Facebook person. But here's the numbers you can call in.
Okay, Indiana, 219-933-9922. Suburbs, 708-445-9922. Chicago, 773-288-9922. Start calling in. Time is of essence right now.
First person that calls in that has the answer will get the prize if you're a Facebook person as well. Hey, people in the radio audience and family and friend are not able to get this prize. Please do not call in. Stewards, I want you all to talk about that. We were talking about, you know, what happens when, you know, you kind of fall out of love. What do you do? And I think one person said, you know, when you don't like them anymore. I mean, that's harsh, but that happens sometimes. And so what do we do when that happens?
You know, I can't imagine not liking them per se, but not liking the actions, not liking, you know, something they may have said or did. It's it brings about a conversation. It brings about what my husband has done for me over the years is when I find myself upset about something, you know, I'm just livid. He will hold me and pray.
You know, I'm warm and fuzzy again.
Oh my God! He will hold me and pray, and it's kind of hard to be upset.
That's right.
In the midst of prayer,
when you got the spirit.
You got. Thank you.
When you wrapped in those arms,
and it brings me to a point where, bless your heart, where I can think rationally again.
Yes.
You know, because when I get in those modes, you know, being rational goes out the window.
That's right.
But he's able to, and it's all through the grace of God. It's all through being submissive. You know, and that's not a dirty word.
Yes.
Ladies, right. That is not a dirty word. Mm-hmm. Submissive is a wonderful thing. Mm-hmm. You know, if you know what it means. So when we talk about being in the Word, reading your Bible, do that, and do that together. You know, that's a humbling experience when you can have that together.
And we got a person on the line that has a question. They hung up. You know, some people just don't want to wait. That must have been a question. You must have gotten the answer from what she just said.
Yes.
And so you decide to hang up. God bless you. Thank you for listening to the Let's Stay Together show. Pastor, give us that.
Not pastor.
Well, that's okay. Pastor. You know, they call me pastor, reverend, everything. It's just Reverend McCain. But reverend, I'm sure your pastor will get upset. But reverend, go ahead.
I know you listen to Pastor Michael and Sister Jerry. 35 years together. Let's stay together. Mm. It there's different types of love. We know there's the erotic one that we enjoy a lot of times, especially when we're on a honeymoon. But then there's a marital love that we have to just be there for each other when things are not going our way, and the other person is just not cooperating. Let's stay together. Let's make sure that we are looking after the other one, the spouse, to do as much as we can for them. If we're looking out for them, then we won't be worried about us. And if each other is looking out for the other, then nobody will come up short.
Amen. We do have a caller now. Caller, thank you for calling Let's Stay Together show. How you doing?
Hey.
Hello. Who's calling?
Hello.
Hello. Who's calling?
Hey.
Say your name again. I'm sorry.
It's Renee.
Renee. Hey, Renee. How you doing?
Is this Renee Johnson?
Yes.
Hey, Renee.
Your whole name.
Where you calling from, Renee?
From Bloomington, Illinois.
Hey, man.
My sister. Woo!
Okay, Renee, what do you got to say to us?
Hi, guys. And I know that.
What?
Well, you are breaking up, honey. We can barely hear you. We can barely hear you. So, Renee, can you hear us?
I can hear you.
Okay, just say something real quick. We got a couple of minutes.
I was calling in to win the gift certificate.
Family members cannot win the gift certificate. I'm sorry. Wah, wah,
wah, wah. You didn't hear that.
No, I was too busy trying to get the phone number that Brenda was reading off quickly.
Yeah, family. You know, it's a shame when family members try to call in and get your stuff. That is, honey, we thank you for calling. We got 2 minutes, so we got to wrap it up, okay?
Okay, bye, Rick.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Hey, one of the things I want to let you all know, we've got to, we're just going to have to give that gift certificate and stuff away at the marriage couple retreat or something. One of the things that we've got to realize is that a spouse, you know, when God gives you a spouse, it's a gift.
Yes.
And you've got to cherish and nourish that gift. The Bible tells us that the man is supposed to love the wife as God loves the church. So it starts with the man providing that unconditional love. And so we want you all to remember that an amazing love is something that happens when you put a commitment into it. Baby, you got something you want to say real quick? Thinking, I guess?
Well, only thing I have to say real quick is, baby, what is the show about next week?
Next show is going to be about worship. We're going to have worship leaders coming in here talking about the relationship they have with God and how that relationship transcends into the church. I'm going to, hey, Nate, I know you can't talk to me no more, but how much time I got left? 1 minute. 1 minute. You know, one of the things I'm going to do is that because of my mom, I'm going to go back to an old thing and how they used to end the show with Carol Burnett and how she used to end the song with something like this. I'm so glad we had this time together just to have a laugh or sing a song. Seems we just get started and before you know it comes a time we have to say so long. I want to thank all of our guests, the Howards, the Stewarts, and the Wrights. Thank you for listening to the Let's Stay Together show. See you next Tuesday at 7:30.
Okay.
Listening to Reverend Rick McCain and author Brenda McCain. If you would like to be a sponsor of the show, please contact us at letsstaytogether@comcast.net. That's letsstaytogether@comcast.net, or send your monetary donations and financial gifts to the Let's Stay Together Show, P.O. Box 5532, Lansing, Illinois 60438. Be blessed. Hi, everybody. This is Daryl King, host of the King's Highway Show. Each and every weekday morning, 6 a.m. till 10. Please listen and don't forget to like us on Facebook at Rejoice1023.com. And you can also check us out on your TuneIn radio app at Rejoice1023. And tomorrow, we are partnering up with Apostle Coy Wade as we give you dinner for two for Valentine's Day, a $75 gift certificate, and also Let Them Pray hat and t-shirt combos and some exciting books to give away. And don't forget, Straight Talk with Camille Media. We're all going to be on the show tomorrow, wishing you the very best day of love. Valentine's.